A day has only 24 hours and a week is made of 168 hours in total. But the question is, how well are you spending those hours? Do you have time left after work to spend time with your loved ones, to go for a walk in nature, read your favorite book, or work on your side hustle? Or do you waste a lot of time procrastinating on your phone, unmotivated and confused about why you can't achieve the things you want? Even though how many things you want to do, a day has a finite number of hours, and the more things you do, the less focused you are. If you do more things, the progress for each is minimal to average. That's why we need to prioritize only a few for a definite amount of time until we can reach the goal set for each. The problem is, life is not super organized and always surprises us with events that can help us jump a few steps further or hold us down for a moment. But one thing is for sure, we do have some control over how we organize our time, and this is what I want to share in this video. How to prioritize our activities more effectively in order to minimize the mundane tasks and make room for our wishes. I'm Anneliese, and this channel is a lot about how to get things done productively in order to achieve our goals and become our best version of ourselves. If you hated math in school, well, sorry, but it can actually help us in real life as well. Because this is what we are gonna use today to get our life together, and it is the subtraction formula. Yep, it is invented by me, but it is nothing new. The thing is, it actually works. Yep, and for this, all you're gonna need is a paper, a pencil, an eraser, and of course, a calculator. And as I said in the beginning, we have in total 168 hours per week and 24 hours per day. But in reality, we kinda have a lot less than that. What I'm gonna present to you today is actually a structure that you can use personalized to your life, but for the sake of this exercise, I'm gonna invent a possibility of living in order to show you how it works. The idea is to get clarity and understand how to organize your activities in order to get the best out of them for every week and month. In order to see what you can actually realize in 1 week and what you need to sacrifice and let go completely to make room for other priorities that are more important. But I have to tell you that this is a general plan, just to get a perspective, the idea of what we need to do, what we need to sacrifice, and what time we can win. Okay, so on this paper, I want you to leave room for a column in the left part, and in the other part, we're gonna make a table with 7 columns for the 7 days of the week and another column at the end for the entire week. Yes, and on the left side, we're gonna make 2 main columns of activities, one that is mandatory, another that is wishes, and the left side is a little bonus called buffer, which I'm gonna get to it a bit later, so stay patient. Okay, so for the first column, the mandatory, we're gonna put all our survival primal needs that we need in order to live, like cooking, sleeping, eating, job, all of this. Here I'm gonna put a possible way of living, but for you it might differ depending on your needs. So I'm gonna put sleeping, shopping, house cleaning, job, cooking, personal hygiene, and of course, eating. I don't know if there is something else, but for this exercise, we're gonna stay with this. And then to the wishes, we're gonna get to all the things that we want to do. I advise you to put like all the things you want to do, because it is important to make clear with yourself what you are willing to sacrifice and for what. But this exercise is made for like a week of time, so you'll see how much you can do in a week of them and or monthly. Okay, so for this exercise, I'm gonna put here read, hobby that you want to make it into a new job or a business. Let's say this will be your side hustle. And then we're gonna put going out in nature, cooking a dessert and family and friends. Okay, and now for the mandatory, we're gonna think how much is gonna take us each activity. For me, I'm gonna put the minimum time required for that activity for this example, and also I'm gonna add a little bit of time for buffer in case it takes longer, who knows. For you, you really have to think how much is gonna take that activity in your life, and also add a little bit of time for that buffer. Okay, so for sleep, we're gonna put 8 hours. Then for shopping, 2 hours in the best case scenario. House cleaning, let's say 3 in total. For the job will be 8 hours, and we will add another 2 hours for preparing to go to work and also for commuting to work if it is one. So that will be 10 hours in total, and then another 6 hours for cooking. It can definitely be less for you, but for this exercise will be like this. Maybe you have big family and you need to cook for them. And for personal hygiene, we're gonna put 2 hours. This again differs for everyone, especially if you are a boy or a girl. For me, for example, it takes me 1 hour just to wash my hair. Yeah. And then of course, eating another hour per day. And now you have to put all of this in the week table. So we are gonna subtract 8 hours of sleep from each day, which will mean that from those 168 hours, we will subtract 56 hours and we'll be left with 112 hours in total per week for daily living. And now we have to subtract another 10 hours from Monday to Friday for the job, which will mean that from those 112 hours, we will subtract another 50 hours and we will be left with 62 hours of free living, let's say. I don't know why, but I have a feeling that this video is gonna get depressing. Sorry for that. And what is with that buffer? Well, you know how those things happen, those activities that you don't know when the time flew so fast. Like when you think of something and in your head feels like 10 seconds, but in reality were 10 minutes. Or when you stare too much in the mirror and another half an hour passed by. You have to take into consideration that for each day, some activities can have a delay because surprise events can happen, or we can just calculate wrong and an activity may take longer. But here's why it is also a bonus, because in case those things don't happen and we manage to do the activities faster, we get bonus time for other activities. And for this buffer, we are gonna put 7 hours per week, which will mean that we need to subtract another 1 hour every day for this. And we will also subtract another hour for every day for eating. And we will result in 62 minus 40 hours, will be left with 48 hours for the other activities that we want to do. Which means 4 hours during the week besides work and 14 hours for the weekend day. Okay, so now we have to put all the other mandatory activities in the table, and for this exercise I prefer to leave the weekend as free as possible for the wish activities and to manage to do all the mandatory in during the week. So we're gonna put 2 hours of shopping on Monday and another 2 of cleaning, because you want to be prepared for the entire week ahead. And then we are gonna put on Tuesday 3 hours of cooking and another hour of personal hygiene. And the same on Friday, 3 hours of cooking and 1 of personal hygiene, because you want to get ready for the weekend and be prepared. We have 1 hour left of cleaning, which we're gonna put on Wednesday, and yep, we are done with the mandatory ones. Now before putting the wishes in the table, you have to do some prioritizing. Which will mean that for each activity, we need to put ratings from 3 to 1 by importance. So we're gonna put 1 hobby and family, 2 friends and read and also going in nature, and 3 dessert, because it's not always that important. And here we're gonna see a cool thing that we can group them. For example, we can group friends and family with going in nature, or sometimes with eating, but we're gonna stay at this. So by these ratings, you're gonna start with the weekend. We're gonna put 10 hours of hobby each day, and let's say on Saturday 4 hours for friends and on Sunday 4 hours for family. And now we are left with Thursday, the luckiest day during the week, with 4 hours for hobby or for read, depending on your choice. And now on Wednesday, we can put on 1 week, 3 hours of reading or hobby. And in the other week, let's say 2 hours of reading and 1 hour of dessert. Yes, and this will be the main clear structure of your life in which you want to maximize the time for your side hustle in this period. And in this particular example, for you it can be totally different. For example, you want to have more time for going out and traveling, let's say. And now you'll be able to see if you want to make an activity more important. You know from which other activities you can sacrifice or minimize in order to make room for that one. And this formula is really helping you to make more time for the wishes. And I know that this example is pretty sad, but you have to accept that this is actually a reality for some people, especially those in this hustle culture, which you can see that sometimes we are like this because we don't have other choice. Maybe we cannot go full time on something, or we don't have money to pay someone to do what we need to do, and we need to do it ourselves in our spare time, our little spare time. Plus, you also need to remember about this buffer, which can be a bonus one time for family or other hobbies you want to do. But we have to accept this, that there will always be something we need to sacrifice for in order to do more of other. There will always be this choice bargain we have to do with ourselves. And of course, when things will change and other priorities will come into your life, it is better to redo this exercise and see what you need to cut on to make room for the new priorities. It is not something fixed, you do it once, but it's something that you can do constantly if your life is always changing. For me, it helps me to gain clarity and also better accept what I need to sacrifice. And for other ways of maximizing productivity and making room for new habits, I have some awesome tips in this video, and here is my latest video. Thank you so much for watching and stay till the end, and subscribe if you want more videos like this on productivity. Love you, bye.